strength of late. My trust is in you. I am that I am, God. My trust is in you.
This is Stephen Sirop. I'm Stephen Gbade Ogunlana. It is a 13-minute summary of our one-hour teaching. And presently, I've been talking about understanding faith. What a relevant subject. There are sometimes a subject will be taught out of order or time. But you talk about a subject that is relevant because of the present situations of life. This is the subject. In my own side of the world, they just ease the lockdown concerning the coronavirus saga a little bit, just yesterday or 2 days ago. But you can still feel the fear in the atmosphere. You know, fear is palpable, tangible. But thank God, greater is He that is in us than He that is in the world. If there is a time you need to buffer up on your faith, build your faith, this is the time. And that is why I'm so glad that we are studying this subject of understanding faith. You and me, understanding how to use our faith. We have studied the law of faith. Romans chapter 3 verse 27 says, by what law of works? Nay, but by the law of faith. Faith is a law. That law of faith involves two sections. Number one, confessing with the mouth. Number two, believing with the heart. The two components are the two major components of faith, and we have dealt with each of them. The section we are in now is where I share practical example of how I used faith and how it produced results. Because listen to this, the Bible says we should follow the examples of those who through faith and patience obtained the promise. Who through faith and patience obtained the promise. There is something about using your faith and patience to obtain the promise. And the Bible encourages us to follow the example of such people. I want you to learn from how I sometimes, in a particular situation, use my faith. We can learn a lot from that. Practical example is so tantamount or paramount in understanding the subject of faith. I want to share something, a cogent point today, and it is this. It is not every situation that you use your faith as if you snap your finger to get results. There are some times, my brethren, whereby you need to sit down. It may take years to get results, but the beauty of it is that you get results anyhow. I'm talking about situation whereby you may need to sit down confessing, believing, and yet it may take years for you to get results. Many of us, because of the perspective of our understanding or lack of understanding of what faith really is, we came from the idea that it's a formula that you can just use like you use tablets and you watch for 2-3 days. If there is no change, then you consult your doctor. Faith often is not like that. I'm telling you, you may have a project of faith that may take years for you to execute. There are some situations of life like that. What could be the reason, Pastor? Number one, there are some situations, take the earth As an example, when a condition is linked with your genetic constitution, it may take years before your faith will prevail. Listen to this. As far as God is concerned, there is no difference between headache and madness. As far as God is concerned, but realistically between you and me, among men, we all know that we would rather prefer to treat somebody with headache than someone with insanity. If you don't think what I said is true, ask medical doctors. Ask them, would they prefer a patient that has headache or the one that has brain problem? They will tell you that they would rather prefer the headache one, except if you are talking about the amount of money they will charge them. So as far as human beings are concerned, there are some certain situations we consider tougher, more difficult, more problematic, but not with our God. For with our God, things are possible. There is no impossibility in His dictionary. God has never met a situation that calls impossible. In fact, we can say He doesn't understand the word impossible. It does not exist in His own world. But to you and me, it may take like that. Do you know that we read from the Bible that it took about 25 years for Abraham to get result of his faith? I wonder how many people can remain standing for those years. It took him 25 years. Some things are like that. I said some things, for example, that has to do with genetic constitution. USS. You want teeth changed. Often it's not something like you snap your finger. You may need to stand your faith, confess over and over because of the situation that it involved. Don't forget, there are sometimes that supernatural intervention may come in. And even that difficult situation may be done like this. But naturally speaking, ordinarily speaking, it often doesn't work like that. You need to stand your ground. You need to believe. You need to stand your ground. That's why the Bible says, "Adding don't hold, remain standing." You are an albino. You want to change your skin color. That is often not one of those things that don't get done like this. It is an example of one of those things that may take period of time before it will become executed. There are some challenges like that. Many times, when you use your faith for yourself, you can easily get the results. You can quickly get the results. But many times, when you are using your faith for another, it may take a longer time for result to come in. Why? Because the will of that other third person, the third party is involved. It often takes longer time. But what I want to bring out is the spirit of faith. That is what I'm bringing out in this teaching. I want you to get to the point that no matter how difficult the task, no matter how difficult the challenge, you will not back out. It's the spirit of this message I want you to go home with. I'm talking about using your faith to attack the situation no matter how impossible it looks like. Smewi Goswat was a great man of faith. Someone that knew him said he knew 23 people that he raised from the dead. I'm talking about Smewi Goswat. Someone that really knew him said he knew 23 people he raised from the dead. Like I said jokingly, that is 23 more than yours or mine. But guess what? That man made a statement, and it is worthy of considering. He said, many times when you don't use your faith and get to the end of your faith, you don't see the faith of God take over. By that faith of God, he was referring to the gift of faith. In a nutshell, this is what he's saying. He's saying when you use your natural human faith against situations of life, I'm talking about the faith you get from the Word of God. When you attempt situation, When you get to the end of what you can believe, something supernatural takes over. He said many of us don't experience the faith of God because we never get to the end of our own faith. That is why I'm encouraging you, always use your faith. No matter how difficult the challenge may be, attack it with your faith. Someone asked Kenneth Copeland and said, "Sir, I knew one woman that believed God and still died." Kenneth Copeland said, he looked at her and said, "How do you want to die? Disbelieving God? No, I would rather it be said of you that that man died believing God than to say he died disbelieving God." Don't run away from issues of life. That is what I want you to get from this teaching. Use your faith. Attempt the situation. Believe God. Naturally, it may seem impossible, but I'm telling you, when you attempt things like that, when you get to the end of your faith, you will see God's gift coming. That is what Miwigusworth said. I remember a crusade that we had like that. The rain was disturbing. Before they called me up to preach, it was already drizzling. In fact, the crusade people were already singing, whether it is fire or rain, they will follow Jesus. They have accepted the situation. When I came up, I told them, I said, "We are here to talk about God's power. If God is powerful, he should be able to stop the rain." They said, "Yes." Then I said, "Let's stop it." Now, this is where the difference between some of us and some of you is. Do you know that when I prayed that the rain should stop, I now announced to the villagers, to the crusade people, I said, "We are here to tell you about the name of Jesus, and we have said there is no name like it. If this rain fails to stop, we are liars. Don't listen to us." I put myself on the stop, on a point, hot seat. Don't you think God will respond? He has to. He has to. I put him in a box. I said, "Everybody listening to me under this microphone, if this rain fails to stop, I'm a liar. We are all liars because we have come to tell you that there is nothing like the name of Jesus." Under 2 minutes, the rain stopped, not only for that day, till all the other days of the crusade, people started coming out of their hut. That what is going on there? Who are these people stopping rain? But that rain would never have stopped if not that I attempted it. Never shy away from attempting situation. Use your faith. Your faith can produce results. It may take you years. Don't back out. Don't take no. That is the spirit that differentiates men from boys. Are you a boy or you are a man? Men don't turn back. I'm Reverend Gbade Ogunlana. GbadeOgunlana@gmail.com. Have a glorious time. Thank you.